So I turn it off and I start the recording, and then I go through my process of playing the different sounds. Here, I'm going to leave a little bit of hum so that I can cut later properly and have a perfect transition between the power on and the hum. Then that's enough, so now we can go with swing. I wait a little bit so that I can identify the wave in the waveform where I am. Go for the clashes. Okay, and then I wait a little bit and power off. Then I'm ready to save. So I'm going to save that in the dark side font. I already have the original mixdown, but I'm going to make a mixdown 2 here just to show you how it works. Then it's saved. I can power down everything, close the application, and then I'm going back to my dark side folder, and I get the mixdown 2 into SoundForge, and there we are. So the file is obviously longer than expected because the buffer is made that way. So I'm going to remove what is unnecessary for now. I'm going to make a complete resampling in one shot of the whole mixdown file so that you don't need to resample individual files after that. So I check that the frequency is correct, and you need, of course, the interpolation to be accurate and have a nice anti-aliasing filter so that you remove everything that is eventually above 22K. What else to say? Well, basically the files that I used were already in 22K, so there is absolutely no risk that you have higher frequencies, but just in any case, you apply the anti-aliasing filter. I have to resample to 22K because the file was output by the Saber sound mixer software in 44.1K. Here we go, filter, and then we have it. We save it just to be sure, and then we create the file. So let's start for the power on. You hear some bit of clicks and so on. This is my fucking Vista computer, but the sound is of course good quality. You just have to trust me. So I'm going to pick up this as a power on sound. You have to make sure that the hum has reached its proper volume before stopping the cut. Otherwise, you will still have the hum coming up, and which means the power on sound is unfinished. So can be this. Maybe eventually a little bit more. So make sure you keep this selection in place because we're going to use it afterward. Now, conventions. Well, okay, for the very beginning, we are going first to remove the silence at the very beginning, then selection. Select it again. Conventions. I always start a waveform with upper part of the wave, an upper part which it is something that goes above zero like that, and ends as a lower alternate. So in here, I'm going to select this. I have an option here which is very nice. It's auto snap to zero, so it makes sure that all my selections are going to the zero crossing. It's extremely convenient, so make sure you have that set up. So I'm going to play that again just to be sure. And then I go copy paste, control, oops. Ah! I've lost what I wanted to do. I badly clicked. Let's do it again. So, keep up with what I was saying. Whatever I select, it's lower side of the waveform. Now, this one is good. So, I go with Control C and then Control N for new one. I make sure it's a 22K mono 16-bit. And go Control V, and I have my waveform that I'm going to save just after. There you go. Now you want to make the hum, and you want the hum to be perfectly synchronized with the beginning of the power on. So you're going to drag and revert the selection like that, which means that the point here is exactly the end of the power on sound. Then you have to see exactly what sort of hum duration you had initially in the file. It's pretty obvious to notice. If you look at the shape of the envelope here, you can see that there is a repeat here, clearly. So I don't need to take all that hum. I can do probably something like this. And if you remember what I said before, you need to go. Oops, where is it? You need to go with a rising edge and end with a lower edge. It's a long part, and I'm still zooming. There you go. So here I'm not placed properly. I'm going to go here, for instance, so it doesn't want here. So now I'm going to listen the hum to make sure that it's seamless, and I'm going to play with a loopback. The little clicks again are not anything you should be worried about. It's just my computer that is behaving like this. So the loop is perfect. Copy, new file, paste. And you go saving that at the right place. I'm going to make a TM folder here. And save that as hum. And this one, we're going to save it as power on.